Hello everyone, welcome to the class. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about the detailed structure of myofibril, or we can call it as microfilament, which is present in the sarcoplasm, that is the cytoplasm of the muscle cell, which we have discussed in our previous lecture. So let's talk about the same. You can see the structure, a cylindrical, a rod-like structure. This is of a myofibril. Okay, this is a myofibril. This myofibril is consisting the bands, as you can see over here. The bold one, the red color one, the thick band. Okay, and you can see the blue one, thin lines or thin band. So these are going to form the striations. The main characteristic of the skeletal muscle fiber, that striations are present. That striations is because of the arrangement of these contractile protein within the cell. Okay, that will give a kind of appearance of the dark band, light band. Okay, let's see the same in the detail. You can see these thick red color filaments, they are of the contractile protein called myosin. Okay, the thick one are of the myosin. The thin one, the blue color one, they are of actin, thin filaments. Got it? So during the process of the contraction of the muscle, what is going to happen? They are not going to shorten in their length. What is going to happen? They are going to just overlap each other. Okay, these actin filament will come close to each other, fine, and that results into shortening the length of the muscle fiber, resulting into the contraction. So here you can see this zigzag line, which is bisecting the actin filament. Okay, actin ke filament ko jo yahan pe bisect kar rahe, this actin filament is bisected by the zigzag line. This is Z line. Okay, made up of the connective tissue. Same. You can see over here in the next band or next arranged, parallelly arranged actin filament. Again, it is bisecting another Z line. Okay, in that way, keep on, like many repeated units will be there. So this particular portion, the portion between, the part between the two Z lines, one Z line, second Z line, in dono ke beech ka jo part hai, that is termed as the unit of contraction, term as sarcomere. So sarcomere is a unit of contraction, means the contraction is occurring within this particular region, and that results into the shortening of the length of the this muscle cell. Fine, clear? So this is Z line. Now you can also see one dotted line in between the myosin layer, or we can say myosin bands. This one, the red color one, this is dissecting the myosin filaments. Okay, these are arranged and this is crossing between them. This is M line. So you can remember by that M line is present in the which myosin filament. Okay, myosin filament jahan pe arrange hai. We'll see that regions also. So that M line is present in myosin, Z line is present in actin. Okay, so this particular part is sarcomere. So this is one sarcomere, then another extended, another sarcomere. In that way, the microfilaments are formed. So here we'll see the structure of one sarcomere, which is containing the actin and myosin, and what about that A band, I band and all. Okay, let's talk about the same. So if I'm going to take this region,
thank you.
So these are the two Z lines. Two Z lines. This is Z line 1 and this is another Z line. Over here, what is present? The myosin and actin filament. The thin one okay, these are you can cross them kyunki is side mein present hone wala center se pass hone wala hai. So this is got it, and in between them what is present? The thick this thick one is of myosin because they are made up of more number of the meromyosin which are the monomer. We'll discuss that in the structure of contractile protein. Now this particular this we have discussed. See, this is the sarcomere. Fine, this region okay. Till that particular area where that myosin filaments are extended, even they are overlapping the actin. This region is going to appear dark when it is observed under electron microscope, and this is termed as A band. Okay, myosin band is going to form dark band, A band. N isotropic band. Okay, this is also dark band. Got it? Now another one. From this to the this till that point where that actin is extended. Okay, both the sides of the Z line till here and till here. This region. This is I band. Okay, this is isotropic band, or we can call it as light band. Thin hai, so that is lighter. Thick hai, that is darker. I band and A band. I band is of actin. A band is of myosin. After this, you can see this M line. This is going to pass from the center of the myosin. This is M line. Now H zone. So H zone is which one? Just see that particular region which is not that particular region of myosin which is not overlapped by actin. So this one. Only and only myosin. In this region, this much. Okay, we are not considering this. We are taking only this region, which is not overlapped by the actin filament. This is H zone. Got it? So this is all about the actin and myosin arrangement in a myofibril. Okay, just give a quick recap to the topic. A band is going to represent the myosin. Till that overlapping of actin also. So this is the A band. I band is of actin, which is on the both the sides of the zigzag line. This is I band. M line is passing through the center of the myosin. Z line crossing or bisecting the parallel line of the actin filaments. Okay. H zone is only the purely myosin region which is not overlapped by the actin filament. Fine. So I band will form the light bands and A band will form dark bands. Got it? This much. Thank you.